In this video, you will learn how to use Logistic Regression Learner and Predictor nodes to train and apply a logistic regression model. Let's jump into it. For this example, take a look at the dataset containing chemical properties of wines. Your goal is to train a classifier to determine whether a wine is red or white, based on the provided features. The target column color comprises two classes, red and white. All the independent variables are normalized, and the dataset has been partitioned to the training and test dataset. The training data is passed on to the logistic regression learner node. Now let's take a look at the configuration window of this node to set up a logistic regression model. First, you need to select the target column. Here, you select the column color. Then you specify the reference category from the pull-down menu. You choose red in this example. That means your logistic regression model will be calculating the probability of white wine. Next, you specify the solver, or the algorithm used to find regression coefficients. Here, you can choose a stochastic average gradient method. Here, you can select features to be used as independent variables in a model. In this particular example, we select all features in a dataset. Under the Advanced tab, you can set the option for regularization, a remedial method to avoid overfitting. The available options are uniform or no regularization, Gauss regularization, as well as Laplace regularization. The node produces three outputs. The top output port contains a trained logistic regression model. This is passed on to the logistic regression predictor node to apply the train model. The middle output table contains the regression coefficients. This table also contains p-values of the regression coefficients, describing their statistical significance. The last table contains iteration numbers and log likelihood for each iteration. Once the model is trained, you can apply it to the test data to produce predicted outcomes using the logistic regression predictor node. To the top input port, the trained model from the logistic regression learner node is introduced. To the bottom input port, the test data from the partitioning node is passed on. In the configuration window, there's an option to append columns with predicted probabilities for different target classes. We check this option for this example. In the output table, a new column with the predicted class is appended. In addition, two additional columns with the class probabilities are appended to the output table. In this example, these columns show the probabilities of red and white wines. Similar to other classification algorithms, the output table from the logistic regression predictor node can be used to assess the model performance. The target column and the prediction column can be compared in the scorer node to assess the prediction accuracy and other prediction metrics. The prediction probability columns can be used in the ROC curve node to draw an ROC curve and to estimate its area under the curve, another metric for model performance. In this video, you have learned how to configure the logistic regression learner node to train a logistic regression model, how to apply a trained logistic regression model with the logistic regression predictor node. You have also learned the output from these nodes and how to use these outputs to assess your logistic regression model.